All right, cool. So, checking out King's Knight here, which is a game that we saw at PAX West on the show floor. It's kind of sandwiched right next to Final Fantasy 15 Pocket Edition and the what was the other game there? I can't remember the name of it. The other Square Enix MOBA. Adomine, I actually haven't, to answer your question, Carter, I haven't even loaded it yet, so I couldn't tell you. So we played this on the show floor, and it was kind of silly because like Jared was having problems with it, and I think it's because we just like rapidly moved through the tutorial. So spending more time with it now, hopefully, and you know, we'll see. All right, agree to terms of use. Over 700 megabytes of game data will be downloaded. All right. Please enter my player name. Just... Okay. All right, so I guess we'll do both hands. I'm playing on my iPad. Yeah, I don't even know what the repair app button does. It seems not. Why am I doing this again? All right, yeah, let's do the tutorial. Oh, so I think maybe this was the problem at PAX, is that there wasn't a tutorial. Yeah, I don't get these downloading things first. Like if it's some random game, like if I it's a random Wednesday and I've downloaded a bunch of games, like I hit a point like this where it's like, all right, we're downloading all this shit. That's usually where I hit the home button and play something else. I mean, admittedly, that was not as bad as some of the other ones that I've played. So I think part of the problem that we had at PAX was that oh shit. The way that they had their little demo set up, and maybe we just got involved in a game where someone had already completed the tutorial, but we didn't have any kind of tutorial, so it was just like Jared just kind of like bumbling around. Right, unleash one of these attacks. Yes, the King Might attacks deals great damage to even the most powerful fiends. Be aware, to unleash a King's Might attack, you require MP. It's weird green Charizard thing says you can buy MP by landing attacks on enemies. Don't forget to switch out one of us if you are in danger. Alright, cool. So you can switch between dudes. Oh, this is kind of cool. I like the auto attack mechanic. I don't know, we'll leave that off though. Alright, so this is my dinosaur dude. And then I've got old wizard guy, or maybe I was playing as. I love how this is just like particle effect bonanza. Need to hurry and save the princess. Yeah, I've considered the possibility that Jared sucks. Although Jared is infinitely better at video games than Brad ever was, so that's big upgrade. Oh, these fire things are crazy. So, this game is like a combination of like a dungeon crawler meets a how do I just go straight? How do I jump over these? Oh god, what am I doing wrong? Help, help, help. Huh. I don't know. It's like a dungeon crawler meets a vertical shooter kind of thing. which I think is pretty cool. Tolfaden release Princess Claire at once. Rayjack. It's chosen heroes. Unhand the princess, says our dinosaur dude. Believe for a minute that you'll get away with what you've done. Wahaha, such a hollow bluster. You will prove a most amusing distraction. We have the Holy Sword Fixer as our ally. We shall feat you, Tolfaden. Alright, so we need to destroy parts. Get the Final Fantasy break, which I guess is a thing. Just go wild on her. Oh. Ah, take that, break. I do really like how just ridiculously over the top this is. Like everything from the music to how it switches to the cutscene of your guy like powering up and stuff. Princess, this way you must hurry. Princess, thank the heavens you are safe. Leave the cheerful reunion for later. Let's concentrate on escaping. Agreed, come, it is this way. Alright, so several bells later. Kalam's blessed holy sword, Rayjack. Curse you, curse you, curse you. This is Darth Maul looking guy. I thought even you prove no match to the holy sword, Tolfaden. You, why are you here? Your time has come to an end, dragon. Go off to the underworld to lament your defeat for now. And then after the victory, the slayers of Tolfaden came to be known as the four heroes of Ulthea. And after Tolfaden's defeat, fiends still roam the land. Threat greatly reduced. Most believe the new era of peace has dawned. King's Knight Part 1, Wrath of the Dark Dragon. Now the winds of fate blow once again in an ominous direction. Alright. Seems really cool so far. Aside from its like weird connectivity requirements and constant data downloading and other Square Enix freemium shenanigans, of course. Oh, hey, more downloads. Cool. All right, so several. Oh, this is the freemium game screen. Several years have passed since Sylphin's defeat, yet the fiend threat grows even stronger. First, you must search for comrades, brave souls that help us protect our kingdom. Of course, there's some kind of gacha system. Alright. You find comrades that are 3-star or higher, you can unlock their side quests. Let's purchase another for free. Oh, I guess we have to go back. Now you must form a party with which you will go on your adventure. Okay. Oh, more downloading stuff. I don't know why developers do this. Like, Hearthstone has proven that people will download a game that's like 2 gigs. Like, if it's a game they want to play, they'll download it and they'll wait and they'll sit on Wi-Fi and get it all at once and not need to deal with this shit. Alright, this is what we loaded, the edit party screen, I guess. Alright, so place comrades you have found in your party. Now let's assign this person as the party leader. Okay. Leader skills grant certain advantages during battle to all party members. The effect will vary according to the party leader, so choose the leader that fits the battle. Okay. Next I will explain individual abilities. Unlock character abilities to give that character new skills in battle. New materials to unlock abilities that I prepared them for this instance. Now let's try unlocking an ability. Alright. God, this is This is always such an unbelievable turnoff for me in any kind of game. Like, so we were talking about like what a turnoff the huge onload stuff is. Like for me, it's like, all right, you played the game and it was really cool and you killed that dragon, remember? And there was all those neat spell effects and you were swapping out dudes and killing guys, and then, you know, you got the big dramatic ending and there was some plot that was vaguely interesting, although kind of contrived like most Square Enix games. Now let's do the 20-minute tutorial, the freemium menus, where we teach you how to do things like max out your guys, roll the gacha system, level shit up you don't care about. And you notice it's like constantly connecting to something in the bottom, so it seems like super linked to the servers that they've got. All right, so before marching into battle, let us take a first-hand look at jobs of your comrades. Each job has its own unique traits. Understanding those traits will be key to victory. Let's proceed to the beginner's hall. Okay. Event banner. Oh, wait. Telling me. Okay. Got it. All right, cool. Yeah, just let me play. Battle quests will include missions that you can complete for various rewards. Take on the challenge. Alright, so we need to do it without using continue, complete the level score of at least 10,000, and without losing a party member. So, fingers crossed we can complete this menial objective. Alright, so warrior is a balanced, easy to use all-rounder. Alright. So I can do an AoE attack if I hold and release. Motion adds an extra attack. Okay. Oop. So I would say where I'm leaning towards writing this up, a headline that's King's Knight, a cool game drowning in freemium shenanigans. Ah, oh, here's the boss, Scorpion Man. Let's do this. Boom. Oh, I thought that was a awfully dramatic death animation. Not. I don't know. I'm not used to the Square Enix world of break animations. All right. So now the scorpion's dead. Cleared the quest. Is this where it's going to teach me how to use more freemium menus? Oh, look at all those missions completed. I got so many freemium gems. Like jobs that match the situation. Alright. What about other jobs at the beginner's hall as well? To gain more of an advantage in battle, you will need superior weapons. Please teach me how this menu works. Well, first let me download the menu. Alright, now that we got the menu downloaded, yes. Let's purchase things. Oh, this is another gacha. I've obtained a more powerful weapon. Equip it once. All right. Do we need to download this menu? Yes, we do. Man. All right. Mindful of weapons that can be equipped with varying according to other job. All right. Yeah. Equip. Let's try to boost a weapon's power. Doesn't hold the equipped like an icon. Right? Oh yeah, boost. I'll need another currency to boost this. One is Zell. Yeah, max that bad boy out. Alright, so we use Zell to temper weapons and increase their level. When a weapon reaches the max level, we can reforge it. Unleash a weapon's true strength through reforging. Seems like a grindy freemium mechanic to me, but it is what it is. Boosting weapons may lead to the addition of new auto skills and King's Mind attacks. Let's return home. Is there something we need to download again? Yes, perfect. Download it. Alright, so this is the map of the continent where our fair kingdom of Ulthiria resides. Places crucial to our story are called chapter points, will be marked on the map. Alright, so we're going to select a quest from the world map and obtain many freemium good things. Alright, so chapter one where there is light. It is here that your adventure begins, but first a brief respite. You are free to move to any location you please. Mayhap you can revisit places you wish to see again. Any point marked on the map is available to you. Waiting to explain battle quests. Until then, be well. Oh, of course there's daily missions. Gotta connect first. Get my login bonus too. More freemium shenanigans. I really should have been taking a screenshot of every single freemium shenanigan because this is kind of... This is just kind of stunning. Just how free to play this game is. Thanks for playing King's Knight. Limited advanced release for iOS, Android, blah, blah, blah. Wait a minute, what's this saying? After limited advanced release of the iOS / Android version of King's Knight, Wrath of the Dark Dragon in Australia, service was temporarily suspended to perform a large scale renewal update in order to enhance quality. You know. Oh, so just telling us that the game is. Game is now available. Missions. Like about a crap we can do to get more freemium junk. Oh yes, achievement bonuses, freemium. Give me all the freemiums. Subquest of a warrior woman. Warrior woman going on escort duty. Alright, so. Come on, Rayjack, you can move faster than that. Are you taking this job seriously? This job you speak of was an escort assignment, was it not? Yes, that is exactly what it is, isn't it? See, most folk would beg to differ. This is nothing more than me serving as a porter for your numerous purchases. If I knew I would be thus, I would have asked Tonio to take the request. Rayjack, you're escorting a lady. You should be more chivalrous. Chivalrous indeed. Come on, let's find another shop. Karen, lead the way. All right, I'll be right there. Are you coming, Rayjack? Sigh, very well. Alright, onto the shop here. What do you think, Jenny? I think that we need to start fighting and have less talking. Maybe you'd like it here. The best shop in the realm. Oh, okay, cool. Perfect. Grr. A fiend. Okay, I can't take this. I'm confused to see what I'm shopping. Let's get rid of them quickly so I can look inside the shop. My blade is at your disposal. Stand there and watch my bags, Rayjack. Again, does she remember that I'm her escort? I am really mad now. I am going to end this fast. Is that it? Alright, so we completed escort duty, and now I guess we're gonna do, what is the name of this quest? Female Dominance. Okay. Not using any items. Not super sure what's happening in this freemium menu, but Playing with a friend is cool. Oh, fell in a hole. Get this chest. Give me this chest. I want this chest. Oh, fell in another hole. So who's ever playing as my friend seems to be useless, and I keep falling into holes. I don't really understand why I'm fighting level 35 dudes. I have nothing. I'm level 1. I wish this other person would do something. Other person, do something, please. Hit your attack button. Alright, well, I died. Can I even kill this thing? Alright, looks like I can. Fell in a hole again. Alright. This is like the level of holes. Like the Disney movie. Over here, dummy. So I do like no damage to these things. I think it like generated that level based on the person that I got paired up with. Oh, I'm not continuing. This is bullshit. Progress on Isley last few minutes of the quest. Yeah, fine. Alright, let's leave the female dominance quest alone for a while and maybe just check out the story quest. Alright, so this takes place somewhere. Very dramatic. I was suddenly come to envelop this wretched world in darkness. Let's see what they can do as you command. The anticipation is most exhilarating. Getting all excited too. You don't get too excited and them. Ha 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 ha. No matter, for that would only mean they are unworthy. Do as you will to carry out my command. Yes, my lord. Now we're at the tavern called the Roost. Tonio, can we impose on you to move that as well? I leave the heavy lifting to me. Quite a mess we have here. Not much time for cleaning lately. Indeed, but this is home and stronghold for our guild. It must be kept clean. Rayjack, can we rest a while? I've grown a bit weary. Very well, then a brief respite. Most kind. Now let us see if there's anything to eat. Jack, is Rayjack here? Auralane brings you here on such a fluster. Apologies for the sudden intrusion, but there are reports of fiends in the area. Fiends? More fiends, it seems. Not a day passes of late without a fiend sighting. Sword Order is currently away fighting fiends elsewhere. We require your assistance. And assist we will we not, Rayjack? But of course, we shall depart immediately. I'm in your debt. The fiends are in Greenfield. It is but a day's ride from here. To battle them. Aye, to battle. Pack lightly and quickly, must depart post haste. Alright, cool. Like, let me just play. I don't want any more freemium menus or anything. I want... Ugh. Of course we need another freemium menu before we can play. Welcome back. Before embarking on a battle quest, let us make necessary preparations. For battle quests, you can take along characters of fellow players as support. I think that was my problem before. Keep in mind that players not being followed will have their not have their leader skills activated. For today, let's proceed without support. Yeah, great. Perfect.
I just want to play.
Alright, so elemental affinity, character's element affects damage dealt by enemies, and the weapon's element affects damage dealt to enemies. Makes sense. Alright, so we got kind of like a Pokemon rock, paper, scissors system. Light and dark, earth, fire, wind, water. Yep, got it. Battle boost. Cool. See, these dudes are more my speed. These, like, level one guys, not the level freaking 40 dudes that I was playing in that mission for reasons unknown. Oh yeah, look at all this shit in the woods. Goblin mages don't got nothing on me. Is that it? No dramatic boss or anything? Alright. Alright, after creating a quest, you'll receive experience, which will help your characters grow. Battles ahead will be challenging, gain experience in battle to strengthen your comrades. Oh, we're gonna learn how to level up. Oh shit, I just unplugged my light on accident. Well. Alright, let's check out another freemium menu. Here's you acquired items during the last battle. Which is one way to obtain items. By the way, did you find any Kalam medals on the battlefield? Each battlefield has 3 Kalam medals hidden within. Find them if you can. Alright, well, cool. I don't know, that's about the first half hour of King's Knight. Seems like, my takeaway here is that this is a very cool game that is just absolutely drowning in freemium shenanigans, which, I mean, is that the worst thing? I don't know. Kind of how these games work. It's just sort of silly to like seeing this kind of like menu is such a huge turnoff to me. It's like not even funny. So all these things we have in the gift box, gotchas out the woe. So yeah, I don't know. Freemium shenanigans the game is basically the name of the game here, I think. Yeah.